welcome to another edition of Minute of the Apes, the daily podcast where we break down the Planet of the Apes movies and swear that I am still Todd and he's still Sean.
Yay.
See, I did it 2 days in a row. I actually know who I am.
Yay.
So, we're at minute 11 through 12, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So, this opens with a swirling shot of the outside of the IKEA spaceship sitting in a body of water. We think it's sinking. We don't know for sure, but we think. And it ends with the sun cresting over the barren mountains and our astronauts saying that perhaps the star is too white. Is that what they say?
I think so.
It's one of those dialogue moments where I thought, what is going on? So, at this point, three humans, no apes, lots of water, and one incredibly fake beard continues to be seen.
Yes.
Okay, so the ship sinking into the water. Some production notes from the Planet of the Apes wiki is that that was a 4-foot miniature that was, it never really says this, at least as far as I can understand, but it was made sort of as a backup because, as I said in the previous minute, they intended to sink the real prop. When that didn't happen, when they couldn't afford the budget for that, they decided to stick this into the tank on the back lot, put a fake backdrop of the Arizona desert, and shoot it in slow motion, which you obviously have to do to make miniatures look bigger.
Yeah, and miniaturized water never looks good.
And then Landon gives us the great acting of going, gone.
God. I mean, that and she's sinking, those are some of the worst first words whenever landing on a new planet.
It may be, but you
know,
it continues to be that as we go along, they continue to find other ways to think of their new home as the worst place on the face of the earth. Or wait, maybe I shouldn't call it the face of the earth.
On the face of the...
the planet of the non-apes, because we haven't seen apes yet. And then immediately, Chuck is resigned that we're here to stay. So there's no hope that they can find anything that gets them off the planet.
No, I mean, their ship's gone. What are they going to do? They've got their rock and metal backpacks. They've got their tiny dinghy. It's not looking good for these people at this point.
I just wanted to know, do I need to beep tiny dinghy?
Tiny dinghy? Just do it anyways. They'll never know what we said.
So is there no space Uber? There's nothing they can't hope to find an alien race and call home?
Well, I mean, they were going someplace potentially 700 to 1400 years in the future. Who knows what would have been there by the time they arrived?
That's very true. And so in this moment right away, I hear the first sign of this film showing the era it was made when we hear Skipper. Landon calls him Skipper.
Yeah.
but then again, why is he such a stinking jerk? Why is Chuck such a jerk and everything? Because at that point, he's asking him for this, and it seems like immediately he's jerky. He's an ass.
Oh, I know. I mean, whenever they're going, hey, where are we? I mean, hey, guess what? I was on the exact same sinking ship as you 5 minutes ago. I just woke up. You see me pull up any charts and look at anything? How am I supposed to know? Hang on, let me just pull something out of my ass and let you know where we are.
Yeah, I was getting water jets sprayed onto my fake beard. I don't know what's going on.
Yeah.
But, you know, if this were today's standards, we would have heard more like a captain or a commander.
Mm-hmm.
With the current relaunch of the Planet of the Apes films, we obviously are seeing what would have happened prior to all this.
Yeah.
But there would have been more reverence for who they were, their positions and whatnot. But
it's very chummy.
I have never, ever, in all the times I've seen this film, looked at this and thought, oh my God, that's horrible. But
wait, you're telling me that the crew, which has a captain that smokes a cigar on the dashboard area, is not completely professional?
No, because this is led by a guy that tells him his answer to any questions is saying we're some 320 light years from Earth on an unnamed planet in orbit around a star in the constellation of Orion.
Orion.
You know, in other words, he just mansplained the entire thing to his crew, and the woman that he wanted mansplained to is dead as a zombie on the sunken ship.
We're going to have apesplaining at some point, aren't we?
That may be a point. Apesplaining, I like that.
Yeah.
I get so much of why the script goes for these things at this point. I get that in drama you have to have people disagreeing for there to be dramatic tension. These people aren't disagreeing, they're just asses.
Well, you
So
know, you're a little grumpy after you first wake up. Imagine tacking on another 1,000 years of that.
well, hell, I was a little grumpy after we taped the last episode and I couldn't remember my own name, so I
There you go.
understand. Those are the notes I have in this. I mean, we're looking at minutes that are definitely setting up the table for the rest of it, and they are laying out some stuff. We know that they're on a place that they don't know where they are. We know that it's been years past.
We know that they're potentially completely alone because every time they pull out to show us wide shots, which are very nice looking, you see nothing. You know, it is no civilization, no animals, nothing.
Which is a fun production note, and I didn't know where to work this in. The wide shots and the shots that we previously saw that were careening over the desert vista and then plunging over that one cliff were shot on a World War I biplane.
Oh, there you go. I did not know that.
With one of the cameramen actually getting out on the wing is what I understood. I hope for his sake that that was misinformation I got, because that's terrifying. You would hope they could just strap that camera onto
Him
it,
out
but
there and just set it off.
yeah. But so that's kind of where we are, minute 11 through 12. Sean, do you have anything else?
Nope, that does it for me as well.
Again, slow minutes, but at least we're building some tension, and we know because of the name of this movie, eventually we're going to get something that looks like an ape, right?
Well, so we're going to go through this. What movie is 1 hour 52? We're going to get to about 1 hour 45. That's when the first ape shows up, right?
If that's the case, then I'm leaving.
They're pulling their jaws on us.
Oh, that would have been kind of cool if you did actually the POV instead of the actual ape.
There you go.
Would you have ape noises in the background and the camera kind of jostling as it ran?
Well, I don't know. I'm assuming that these apes are maybe smarter than people. Why would there just be ape noises?
Whatever, Sean.
That's very specious of you.
So is he going to be a condescending jerk when and if he meets apes? There's a
Yeah, we'll
question to
find out.
ponder. All right, so that wraps up another minute of the Minute of the Apes podcast. Make sure to come out and look for us on our website, minuteoftheapes.com. There you can find links to our email address, our Twitter, our Instagram, our Facebook, our YouTube, everything that you could ever want to interact with us in a social way. Send us comments, send us whatever you want. Just keep coming back. That's all we ask, right, Sean?
Yes, that's all that and money.
Oh, I didn't know we could do that. All right, everyone, thanks so much. We'll see you tomorrow.
Bye.
I hate every ape I see, from chimpanzee to chimpanzee. No, you'll never make a monkey out of me. Oh my God, I was wrong. It was Earth all along. You finally made a monkey.
Yes, we finally made a monkey.
Yes, you finally made a monkey out of me. I love you, Dr. Zayas.